Hey, what's up, guys? Bobby Paul asked me, have you been able to hyperlink and create an action that triggers the chatbot embedded on your website? I thought his idea was a pretty cool use case, so let me show you a simple solution that I came up with. For example, say you're a user browsing the documentation page on Typebot and you want to see a little bit more information about a certain question. I scan the page and then down here I notice this button. A quick side note, this is a button that I created for this example. And if I click on this button as a user, you can see that this question text gets automatically populated here and then asks OpenAI to respond with its answer. So this is a neat little trick to bypass the user to actually input their question to receive an answer and just have to click on it. So that's what it looks like from a user perspective. So next, let me get a little bit more technical and show you how it works. Basically, what I did here was create a button element out of this particular question that you see here, and then gave it a class of FAQ so that I would be able to select or target that particular element with JavaScript. And then once I'm able to target that particular element, on the click event, I'm able to run this function called typebot.open. This is what the function looks like to capture the text from the button element. And here's where I got the typebot.open function or the method to open up the pop-up for the typebot. On the click event, we activate the typebot and then pay special attention to the prefilled variables key that you see here. Because this is where we pass in the user message, which is the text from the button element. And again, we run the getButtonText function in order to capture the text from the button element. And then once we do that, we save it as a variable called user messages. And then once we capture the text that we save as a user messages variable, we create a text bubble that you see here and then pass in the typebot variable called user messages. Remember, this all gets triggered on that button click. From there, we pass in whatever text there is from that button element right into the OpenAI block. We instruct the OpenAI system role to only answer questions, in this case, just to make this example as simple as possible, to answer questions about the affiliate program. What you would probably do here is just pass in all of the content from the FAQs that you want OpenAI to answer. Then we enable the messages sequence. So this provides the chatbot or OpenAI memory of the conversation that's taking place. And then we save the answer as an assistant messages variable, which is what you see here and here. If you're finding this video helpful so far, please consider giving it a like and subscribe to the channel. What I like about this approach is that you can have one dynamic typebot to be activated on different questions like you see here. However, there are a couple of other things that you should consider. For example, maybe you want a typebot to answer questions about every page on your website. Or for instance, in this example, every page on the documentation. The simplest solution is to create a set variable block and then pass in your data about a web page or about your website in there. But a problem that you'll encounter, especially with this documentation example, is that ChatGPT 3.5 has a token limit, which comes out to around 3,000 words or so. So what you need to do is break down that text or that data. Another option is having a look at the tutorials in OpenAI and checking out the website Q&A with embeddings. Check out the documentations, but in a nutshell, what you end up doing is creating a web crawler with Python to scan all the pages on your website, capture the text, and then somehow save the data somewhere. I don't know, I guess as an embedding or some other way. This is actually something that I'm really curious about and want to learn more about. So if you have any information, please share it in the comments below. About 3 weeks ago, I attempted to do something similar where I scraped data with a Python library or package called Beautiful Soup. A lot of things have changed since then, but if you're curious and want to have a look at how I did it, I'll include a link in the upper right of the video that you're looking at right now. Also, I created a different video on how to scrape data using Google Sheets. Long story short, In Google Sheets, there's a function called import XML where you can scrape certain sections of a website. What I like about this approach is that all you need to do is pass in the URLs of the web page that you want to scrape, and then pull the handle down to have the import XML do the scraping for you. From there, you can use Typebot to refer to this Google Sheet to grab the system prompts that you see here. If you wanted to do something with a lot more depth and complexity, for example, like creating a question and answer assistant for a site like the documentation section in Typebot, then you would probably need to do something like the OpenAI example, where you use a web crawler, use Python, and then scrape the entire site and then create embeddings from it. Anyway, I hope you found this video useful, and I'll see you in the next one.